Hello, in this video we will continue with the construction of edge catenoids and edge catenodoids in H2 crosser. Well, first I'm going to talk about something about minimal graphs in SR2R and L3. Well, a graph over some domain omega of M2 kappa can be parameterized in terms of a function u as follows, as here. And well, the mean curvature is this divergence where g of u has this expression. Well, a graph is minimal if this divergence is zero. I'm going to present you some example that I'm going to use later. The umbrella UP centered at P is a complete entire minimal graph. Entire mean that the graph is defined over all H2 that consists in of horizontal geodesic through P. Well, the only point with the where the angle function is equal to u is the point P. Here we can see an umbrella center in the origin, and here an umbrella center in another point that is not the origin. Well, also the here we also given a horizontal geodesic gamma. The surface E is a complete entire minimal graph that consists of all geodesic orthogonal to gamma. Here the angle function is equal to uno along gamma. Here we can see the surface. Here we have gamma and all the geodesic orthogonal to gamma. We have this surface. Okay. Now we are going to focus in the construction in the initial minimal piece in SL2 and L3, where we consider the triangle TAB in H2 or in R2 in the case of L3, with vertex P0 here, P1 and P2, and the length of the segment. This segment has length A, this segment has length B, and the segment P1, P2 has length L. Here the same A, B, and this length is L. And also the angle in P0 is P over 2. Well, the values a and b can be infinity. Here in the case of a is infinity, we have that this point is ideal, and if b is infinity, then the point p2 is ideal. And well, in this case, if a is infinity, then we have here a band like this, and if b is infinity, then we have a band like this. Okay, then we are going to consider sigma AB as the minimal surfaces in this space kappa tau obtained by solving the Jenkins-Ovens problem, that is a Dirichlet problem with boundary value 0 over the segment P0, P1, 0 over the segment P0, P2, and infinity in this segment. Okay, we have something like this. We can obtain the surfaces using resolved by Mailo, Plehner, and Jones, and well, then we extend this surface in order to obtain the following biaxial symmetry along this horizontal curve. We have something like this. Well, I recall that when A is infinity, then this vertical geodesic becomes ideal geodesic, and well, in the case of SL2R, when A and B are both infinite, and then here we have a complete circle surfaces. Okay, now I call this vertical geodesic gamma 1 and this gamma 2, and we have that the angle of rotation satisfies that here in gamma 1 the derivative is negative because the normal rotation that direction, and here the derivative of the angle of rotation is positive because the normal rotating in this direction. So we have this behavior. Well, when h is less than 1 over 2, we have that when a is infinity, this point become ideal, and here we have in the surface we have a vertical ideal geodesic, and it can be proved that the angles, the total variation of the angles go to zero by using the formula in the other video, and well, we have the same in the case of p equal to infinity, that the total variation of the angle in this case is zero. Okay, and what's happening in the case of h equal to 1 over 2, then we are in E3, and in this case this vertical geodesic that appear here, when our b is equal to infinity, disappear. We haven't got this behavior. Okay, now we consider the conjugate H surface in H2 cross R when A and B are finite. We have the following. We have the initial minimal piece here. We have this horizontal two curve, and that this curve goes to a curve containing in a vertical plane. This curve goes also to a curve containing a vertical plane, and the angle here is p over 2. Then the vertical curve gamma 2 goes to a horizontal curve containing in a curve containing in a horizontal plane, sorry. And remember that the normal has to point to the interior of the domain. Then here, this ideal geodesic in infinity, it can be proved that goes to a vertical ideal geodesic, and also the like this length. Remember that is L. Then this length is also L, and well, and finally the curve gamma 1 go to a curve containing in a horizontal plane. Remember that the normal, like the derivative is negative, has to point to the story of the domain. Then we have something that project like in this blue region, and then we extend by reflecting over this vertical plane. We obtain a piece that complete this region, and then reflecting over the plane. That contain the curve gamma 1 star and gamma 2 star, we obtain a complete surface invariant by a vertical translation of 2L, that is 2 times this length, and we call these surfaces H saddle towers. Okay. About the embeddedness of this surface, we know that the total variation of the curve gamma 2 and gamma 4 is less than pi, and also the derivative is positive, then the curve gamma 2 star and gamma 4 star are embedded. Also, when b is large enough, we can ensure that the curve gamma 1 and gamma 3 are embedded, because in the limit p equal to infinity, they become in ideal curve or constant curvature to h in h2 times minus infinity, while under a continuity in the Daniels conjugate. This is in the case of h less than 1 over 2, and well, it could happen that the surfaces sigma b star is not containing in the slack h2 times minus l 0, meaning this plane is at height minus l, and this plane is at height 0. can happen. If the surface is not containing this slab, then when we reflect over this horizontal plane, we have that the surface is not embedded when we have reflect. Okay, now I'm going to prove that this in this case not happen. Okay, I'm going to prove this claim one, that the angle function of sigma b only takes the value one at the center of the center QC, where the surface take this value one at the center, because we have two orthogonal geodesic horizontal geodesic through Q0, then the normal in this point is 0, 0, 1. Okay, then we assume that there is another point in sigma where the angle function is 1, and we are going to distinguish three cases. The first case, if the projection of this point is in the interior of the triangle, then we consider the umbrella UQ that is tangent in the point Q to the surface sigma AB, and we know that by the maximum principle it form a equiangular system of at least two chords that they cannot enclose compact loop. Then we have the following. Here in the picture we are drawing the projection, and we have that this curve in the intersection have to arrive to the boundary of sigma AB, because the surface the umbrella is a complete surface. So, well, the curves have to arrive to the boundary. They cannot arrive to this side, because the umbrella takes here bounded values. It can arrive to this corner and also to this corner, but not both of them to the same corner, because both surfaces are graph. And if two curves arrive here, then we have a compact loop, and this is not possible by maximum principle. So we can have an endpoint here, another endpoint here, and well, the other two endpoints are in this segment and in this segment. Maybe two here, maybe two here, or one here, or one here is the same. The point is that we have these two endpoints, and then like the umbrella is composed by all geodesic through Q, then we find a geodesic in a horizontal geodesic in the umbrella joining this point with Q, and also this point with Q. And then we have found a polygon in a polygon in the Capataud space that is composed only by horizontal geodesic, and this is not possible because the constant tau is not zero. So this here we achieve a contradiction. The second case is that the projection of the point is in the segment P0, P2. Then we also consider the umbrella tangent in Q, and the intersection now are this segment P0, P2, and also another curve here. We know that this curve has not enclosed a compact loop, so it cannot arrive to the segment P0, P2. Also, it cannot arrive to this side, because the umbrella take bounded value here. But it can also arrive here, because the umbrella here take negative values. So the only possibility that this curve enclose a compact loop. So we achieve also a contradiction. The third case is that the projection of the point is in the segment P0, P2, like here. Then we consider the wall quadrilateral, the wall square, and the surface I whose ACID contain the segment P0, P2, P0, P2, this segment. Well, we know that this surface is tangent in P0 and also in Q, but because the angle function of I is one along this geodesic. Okay, then the intersection between I and the surface sigma EB are this horizontal two curve and also another equiangular system of curve here in Q, but there are not enough corner to this curve, so it has to enclose a compact loop, and it is not possible by the maximum principle. Well, with this we finish this claim one. Well, I'm going to prove now this claim two, that the surface sigma AB star is contained in this slab. Okay, well, the proof is I'm going to sketch the proof. First, if the surface escape from above, then we can consider a minimum plane that is tangent in this maximum, and the normal point like here, point the normal is 0, 0, 1, and we have the following. We have a minimal surfaces that is tangent to a edge surfaces, and is about the these surfaces, and the mean curvature of the minimal plane is less than the mean curvature of these edge surfaces, so it cannot be possible by the maximum principle. So the surfaces cannot escape from above to the slab. What's happening the surfaces escape from below, then we know that the only point where the angle function is you know is the center. So we consider the conjugate curve of the segment Q0, Q1, and we have the following. Here is the point Q0 where the surface achieve a minimum and the normal is 0, 0, 1, and we know that in this point this curve gamma star goes like thick. Then the only possibility is that there are another point with angle function equal to uno, and also another point by symmetry. So by claim one, this is not possible, and this finish this claim two. Well, okay, now I am going to talk about the limit case when a is equal to infinity and the mean curvature is less than 1/2. Okay, in this case we have the edge catenoid. We have that the curve gamma 1 and gamma 3 becomes ideal vertical geodesic, and then the conjugate curve becoming ideal curve of constant curvature 2/8 in H2 times minus infinity, this curve gamma 1 and gamma 3. The curves gamma 2 star and gamma 4 star are embedded. This curve gamma 2 star and gamma 4 are embedded because we are in the case that the derivative angle of rotation is positive, and also the total variation is less than pi. And also we have that the surface, the half surface is contained in this slab because of the same argument than before. Then we reflect the surface sigma infinity B star about the horizontal plane containing gamma 2 star and gamma 4 star, and we obtain a complete embedded edge surface with 2n and genus 0 that is symmetric with respect to a horizontal plane and also to a two orthogonal vertical plane. We call this surface the edge catenoid. And what? And now the case of b equal to infinity and the mean curvature h less than 1 over 2. Well, now we have this, we consider the conjugate S surfaces of these surfaces, sigma A infinity star, and the curves, now the curves gamma 2 and gamma 4 become ideal vertical geodesic, and then the curve gamma 2 star and gamma 4 star becoming ideal curve of constant curvature 2h in h2 times plus infinity, like this, or maybe like this. We don't know when the curves gamma 1 star and gamma 3 are embedded, but we can say that when I is large enough, this curve are embedded because in the limit they are embedded and we have a continuity in the Daniels conjugation. And well, and also the half of the surface is continuing in this region because they are limit of the saddle tower that is contained in a slab. Well, then we reflect the surface about the horizontal plane containing gamma 1 star and gamma 3 star, and we obtain now a complete Alessandrov embedded H surface with 2n and genus 0. We know that there are embedded examples when I is large enough, and now I'm going to prove that this example in fact occurs when I is small enough. So, and this show that the crust property does not hold because here we have a minimal graph over a convex domain, and this surface is not embedded, and in particular is not a graph. Well, the crust property, for proof that the crust property does not hold for this value of the mean curvature, we consider the function rho eb, that is the distance of the projection of Q0 star and the curve gamma 2 star or gamma 4 star in the same. That is this distance in the this horizontal distance, the distance between this center and this curve. Okay, I remember that this distance can be computed the integral of the angle function along the segment in the surface sigma, not in the surface sigma star. Okay, when b is equal to infinity, then this distance runs from 0 when the length of this segment is 0 and the angle function is bounded to this quantity that is the distance in the case of the circ surface when a and b are infinity. That is a constant, a finite constant. Well, this shows that when a is small enough, the curves gamma 1 star and gamma 3 star are not embedded. This is because when I is small enough, this distance is small enough, and then the distance between these two curves is small enough, and then they have to intersect each other, like in the picture, and then the curve gamma 1 star and gamma 3 star are not embedded. Well, this happened in the case of p equal to infinity because the surfaces contained in the convex part of this H cylinder. Okay, here we can see the domain of the H catenoid and H catenodoid. Here we have the domain of embedded catenoid, and here we have two domain of a node embedded catenodoid, embedded catenodoid. Well, now I'm going to say something about the case of h equal to 1 over 2. The initial minimal piece is in nil3 and is foliated by a straight line but not by geodesic. It can be obtained integrating a ODE. The surface is sigma infinity b, were obtained by Daniel and Haskell, and this is the case where the derivative of the angle of rotation is positive along this vertical geodesic, and we obtain the surfaces sigma a infinity, where the angle of rotation, the derivative of the angle of rotation is here negative. This is the surface sigma infinity b, and b is this distance, and the angle of rotation is positive along this geodesic, and this is the surface sigma a infinity, where this distance is a, and the angle of rotation here along this vertical geodesic are negative. Okay, well, then we consider the conjugate surfaces, and we have the 1 over 2 catenoids sigma infinity b, that all of them are embedded, and well, the main difference to the other case is that in this case the curve gamma 1 star and gamma 3 star disappear in h2 times minus infinity, because here we haven't got a ideal vertical geodesic, so the surfaces, they are not asymptotic to or cylinders. In some sense, it's like this or cylinder collapse in a straight line. Okay, and also the 1 over 2 catenoid, that is the conjugate of the surfaces sigma a infinity. We can prove that all of them are not embedded. And well, in this case also the curve gamma 2 star and gamma 4 star disappear in h2 time plus infinity, and also they are not asymptotic to all cylinder. In this case it's like the all cylinders go to a wall cylinder. Here in the picture the dark region are double in the domain. Well, in this case we can compute the curvature of this curve, this curve in this case gamma 2 and gamma 4, and in this case gamma 1 and gamma 3, and well, this picture looks like realism, they are not a draw. And well, when this I finish this video, and thank you for your attention. I hope see you soon.